taking pictures, okay? And I don't know this, right?
No.
And I said,
wrong number.
Let's see.
New prep of one.
Okay, for example, I do nothing, right? I'm here. Oh, no. Okay, I hear nothing. That means I cannot hear anything. You understand?
Thank you. Demain matin, 2. À midi, 2. Après-midi, 2. À soir, 2. Ça fait combien?
Ça fait 8.
Ça fait 8
picades.
On est assez long pour mourir, net souffrant. On prend un matin, on a soif fini.
Ou fini.
Pas besoin rien qui a alcool. Même ou bien. D'accord, on va vous y aller. Demain, tout pour prendre. Souvent, on va battre des pièces sur la fête à la caille. Et ça, quand on va ah ouais, tout là est pour Dieu. Sous ça, tu as un problème. Oh, t'as des mon gars avec si tu as bon problème, pas si tu as bon problème, pas péter encore, mais pas péter tout. Il y a des gars, moi, je suis bien. Il y a
It's morning of Saturday, and we're getting ready to go to the airport in about 20 minutes, and really glad to be going home. As you can see through some of the pictures, hopefully, and the videos, that Haiti way of life is a very difficult one. I have to say this trip has been very discouraging to me, and where I don't know if I could have hope in these conditions that the Haitians live with every day. I don't see a government presence helping the people or employing the people to take care of their roads, their sewer, their water, things that their electricity, things that we depend on for our day-to-day life in the United States. We saw about 200 patients every day in our clinics, and you can see some of the locations were quite remote. I think the one that probably touched me the most was the one on top of the mountain, as being the most difficult location. And there's one image that I'll take home. Well, there's a couple of images, several images. That was probably the most touching. The chickens and the little baby chickens running around in the farm, my pharmacy and the lab, and the mother that had a baby close to her body, and then two other children who were 3, maybe, and 5 years old, and one of the little girls was dressed in a white dress and her black shoes, and she had her black pocketbook, and it was dusty as could be. There's no telling. We heard that how far they walked there. We heard that some people walked 2 hours to come to our clinic there. It was painful when I ran out of medication. And it was painful when we didn't have medication that we needed. We brought thousands of tablets of medication, and it did help. There were some people who really needed medication. Well, all of them needed vitamins and iron and worm medication and scabies. Everyone was treated with that. Say, I don't know if I could come back and do this again. It was really difficult. And discouraging, but I don't know. I'll see how I feel in a little while. But as you can see, it's 6:40 in the morning on Saturday in Leogane, Haiti. And the people are up. They're vibrant people. They're up setting up their shop to sell and make a living. And they're gathering their water and planning out their day. So there are a lot of positives here. Some really beautiful heart and Christian people here. Maybe that is inspiring this trip. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the pictures.